Hey, what's up everybody? My name is Trophinuts and welcome back to Mass Effect Andromeda. I'm standing here inside of a hologram of an Asari named Avena. Of course, an artificial intelligence program here to guide us, but of course she's not of any use at the moment. Is there anything else here that might be of use? That's what we're here to find out, aren't we? So we're still on the Nexus. And it still seems as abandoned as it was before. I don't know why we're not wearing a suit if we're expecting trouble.
There's a guy. Maybe he's got champagne.
Human male, DNA-based organism, 100% human. This is likely a member of the Nexus support crew. Okay. Hello, sir?
Why don't we just ask that guy?
Yes, Liam. Jesus Christ. Hello?
We're from Ark Hyperion, and wondering where everybody went.
What?
Did he hear you?
Did
you say an Ark?
I did.
Yeah, we just got in.
And for what it's worth, your VI over there could use an update.
But we thought you were all dead.
What?
Why?
Or captured, or lost in dark space, or...
But why did
here.
You think that?
You have no idea how much this means.
I don't believe it.
Ooh, that sounds... Ooh, a Turian. Hello there.
I'm Tyrion Kandros. I lead our militia on the Nexus.
Okay, Tyrion.
I'm Sarah Ryder. This is Cora Harper and Liam Costa, part of the Pathfinder team.
I'm sorry for the confusion. Our sensors told us an Ark had arrived, but Helios is notorious for scrambling equipment. We thought you were just another malfunction.
Oh, why is that?
But aren't you expecting us?
You're the first Ark we've seen. After a year of waiting and no sign of the others, we shuttered this area and stopped looking.
You've been stranded for a whole year?
Longer. I'll fill you in on the way to Op Center.
Okay, then. So how did you guys end up here, then? I still don't know. How does that even work?
Everything that could go wrong with our plan has. We arrived 14 months ago. Right away, we hit a band of dark energy that knocked us off course.
We're familiar with it.
Then you'll know why we call it the Scourge. We lost whole sections of the station. A lot of people died. No power, no food. The chaos went on for months. It finally led to armed rebellion. When order was restored, the insurgents were banished. Exiles, we call them.
Are things back to normal?
Not even close. But you're here now, so maybe the worst is over.
No word from the other Pathfinders?
No word from anyone, period.
Any threats from the locals?
So far, we've stayed hidden. We're here.
You guys go ahead. I'll check out the security situation.
You should know our command structure has been fractured. Some of us are filling in for leaders who died.
So there was a rebellion.
He said drop everything and report for duty.
And no one was expecting an Ark to finally show up.
Docking procedures.
Okay,
going across
seems like
the
there's
board.
A lot of people and
stand by to merge Hyperion
older
power
aliens
to the grid.
In here. Okay, then. Still weird that the lights are dimmed like that.
The
everywhere.
Crew of the Hyperion.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Tyrion? I'm Jaren Tan, director of the initiative. You have no idea how much your arrival means to us.
Okay. Thank you, Jaren. Means more to us, probably. Although, I don't think, as we've been in stasis for 600 years, these guys are waiting for us for more than a year, so we're here to assist.
We've heard about what happened, and we're ready to help.
We could use any supplies you have. Food, water, we're short on everything.
This is Foster Addison. She oversees colonial affairs.
And you're a Salarian.
Where's the Pathfinder?
You're looking at her.
You're not Alec Ryder.
My
father's
dead.
Yeah, you're right.
He made me his successor.
Alec is dead.
Yes, he is.
Please understand, the entire initiative is at risk. None of the Golden Worlds panned out. They're a bust, and there's been no word from the other Arks.
What happened to them?
Unknown. Our supplies are nearly depleted. Rationing bought us some time, but even that's running out.
We need to find more resources, but that takes people, and we can't wake them up.
until they have somewhere to live. A golden world.
Now more than ever, we need a Pathfinder.
It now falls to you, Ryder. Are you up to the task?
Hell yes.
I'm ready to step up and do what needs to be done. I can handle it.
Youthful enthusiasm will only get you so far in Andromeda.
And a plastic face will not get you anywhere. Is that?
I'm Nakmor Kesh, superintendent of this station. Hope they haven't scared you off already.
It's nothing personal.
Is that a female Krogan?
Now is the time for on-the-job training.
At least the Pathfinder here seems willing to try. We could use a fresh perspective.
You've heard my concerns. I'll leave you to it.
Because, well, the reason why that is so spectacular is that there was a complete storyline in Mass Effect 3 about
the... Let's have a private word in my office, Ryder. We'll discuss giving you a
the viability of Krogan females, but we never saw many. Okay.
Welcome to the Nexus.
Kesh, it's a mess. A bit like some parts of this game, but thanks for helping.
Thank you for standing up for me there.
Hope's in short supply here. What little we can find should have a chance.
Ma'am, the Hyperion's core is now on...
What kind of a monster was that?
Let me show you something.
That model looked horrible.
An hour ago, that was all dark. But with the power from your ship, you're keeping the lights on. You have my vote.
Okay.
And when the power runs out?
You'd best go talk to Director Tan. Make sure that doesn't happen. And don't be shy. Come see me when you have a chance.
Wow. Is this our base of operations then? Holy shit. You've received an objective. Press options to view your journal. Speak with pretty much everybody. This is gonna be a conversation-heavy episode. Let's speak with Director Tan and Pathfinder Headquarters.
Hello, Console. You and I are going to be very good friends. We'll get you all fixed up and ready to go in no time.
That's a tech-savvy Solarian. Power relays. And is this a green Turian? It sure is. That is creepy looking. Let's check the journal, because it keeps bothering me about it. Nexus Reunion. The Hyperion has docked with the Nexus, the support hub for Andromeda Initiative teams. Speak with Director Tan and Pathfinder Headquarters. Okay then. Well, I have other... No, I don't have other journal. Ah, additional tasks. Getting to know the Nexus. Maybe that's not a bad idea to do first. So Tan is the one I need to speak with eventually. So I need to speak with Kesh, Kandros, and Addison first then. There we go. There was a lot of tutorial messages there, but I'm just gonna skip through them. So, hello, Addison.
Alright, what happened?
To who?
To whom? And your goddamn father. Sorry, my face is tired from dealing with everything. And
her
right
face
now,
is tired. Her face looks
Alec.
Terrible, to
Not
be honest.
How he died. I pulled those logs. What happened with Pathfinder?
Why do you talk like a robot? What happened with Pathfinder? You wanted me to be Pathfinder, yes?
In a moment, it saved my life. But it seems my father meant for me to get the role, eventually.
It isn't hereditary. If we wanted an inbred monarchy, we could have left half our gene stock back home. Not home. The Milky Way. This is home. This mess. We don't have a lot of options, Ryder. Maybe you'll prove your father right. After 14 months of failed colonization, forgive me if I don't hold my breath.
Oh, do I need to talk with you a lot? Because your face isn't all that... It's not really talking about appealing, but just so static. Colonial director position.
How do you fit into the Nexus leadership?
I oversee the actual settlement effort. As the number of outposts is currently less than ideal, my influence is limited. As Tan is quick to remind me. Left a perfectly adequate career as a chief officer. Provincial capital, too. Only a new galaxy could pull me away. And here we are, idling.
Okay, insight into strange tech. What is that all about?
There's also this strange technology. Has anyone studied that?
Oh, yeah, okay. So the pyramid we activated.
Not me. The brains in research. They're supposed to know their business. The current excuse? The tech we dug up on Mars was more advanced, but it was plug and go. The tech here thinks different? I don't know. We've mostly avoided it. And from what the Hyperion logs say about Alex, maybe
mode.
That's good.
What the fuck? Yeah, your face is really starting to make me doubt playing this game, but, the plan for the hostiles, yes, the aliens.
There must be some kind of plan for encountering hostile aliens. We can't have been that naive.
We expected life, not an enemy that refuses to talk. They don't attack, they disinfect. We're nothing until we're bacteria. Sorry, 14 months and you stoop to poetry. That's how bad it is. Not sure who started it, but we're calling them Ket. Kandros will know more. Maybe too much.
You don't trust him?
I trust him to defend us. I do not trust a rising military influence in a supposedly civilian initiative. We came here to make history, Ryder, not repeat it. Ugh, goddamn poetry.
So there, I wanted to just explain myself a bit. I know I complain about her face a lot right now, but it's not so much the way she looks. That's not really the problem, it's the way she emotes. There were a lot of sentences in this conversation we just had in which she constantly changes emotion, which is fine when you're talking about shit, but her face just stays the same. She doesn't react to anything. The only difference we saw was sleepy mode, where her eyes were half closed, and anything else was just robotic static face. But, failing outposts.
You've had no colony successes in over a year? How many tries is that?
Less than you'd think. The Scourge, spoiled worlds, exiles, hostiles. We can't just plop down an outpost and expect picket fences. We need the Pathfinder and Sam to scout, evaluate, and inspire. The initiative promised a goal. Andromeda has not cooperated.
And if it had?
Beautiful utopian horseshit. Colonies that produce and support each other. The Nexus as Citadel, not headed by Tan, or even me.
Yeah, this is me right now. I'm just completely, utterly... I can't. I'm not even... Yeah, she... Based on the voice acting, it sounded like she had some sort of relationship with Alec. So that might be still an interesting thing to go into. And I hope that's the last I see of your face, because...
You called my father Alec.
No offense.
No one does that.
A lot of us joined the initiative because of his vision. What he shared of it, anyway.
Were you friends, or...?
I'm not your new mother, if that's what you're asking. Or his friend. He hated that I didn't use his title. But no one's a pathfinder until they've path-found something. Much like a colonial director without colonies.
So why is everybody calling you a director then? But never mind, I'll be going.
Excuse me, Director Addison.
Ryder?
It's Pathfinder.
Ryder, we're starving here. If we don't get a foundation of outposts to feed the initiative, we might as well be 600 years dead. Alec promised a lot. None of it panned out. That's what you're up against. Why people won't trust you. Why I don't trust you. Prove me wrong.
So aside from not reacting to anything, she's actually a bitch as well. So next up, Cash or Kandros? I actually like Kandros. Although, where the hell do I even need to go? Points me 90 meters. Let's go over there first. Stupid that I need to manually open the door.
Habitat 7. It wasn't even close to livable.
That's been true of every world we've found. Ryder.
But we kind of fixed that, right?
The next expedition.
About time?
Good. I was starting to wonder who was in charge around here.
Director Addison is entitled to her opinion, and mine overrules hers.
Does she know that?
That is...
I oversee the entire initiative.
A valid opinion.
And I have decided to give you a chance to prove yourself.
Thank you.
To that end, the Scourge dealt us a serious blow. Whatever it is... Our scientists theorize it's not natural.
An artificial energy cloud?
It wasn't here when we left the Milky Way. yet it rendered all the Golden Worlds unlivable. Then there's the aliens you ran into, the Ket. They're obsessed with alien structures we found scattered around the cluster. They'll do anything to prevent others from accessing them. It seems murder isn't exclusive to the Milky Way. And now the challenge is to settle a world in spite of all that. This one here. Eos.
How?
You need to increase the viability of the planet so we can establish an outpost. Then we can bring more colonists out of stasis. The more colonists we have, the more resources we can gather to support the Nexus. Everything depends on it. There are 6 worlds we hope to settle.
Okay, but you said every planet you found is unlivable, so how do I...
A good Pathfinder would relish the challenge of solving it.
Oh yeah, that is easy.
I think I should go check on things.
And if I fail, I guess it's no sweat off your back, right? You'll just look for another Pathfinder?
Placing bets on people is part of my job. Some of them pay off. Others...
Don't play games.
The way I see it, you need me. If I pull this off, maybe you'll look like the leader you pretend to be.
But first, you have to succeed at being the Pathfinder you pretend to be.
Yeah, we're all pretending at the moment.
Where's my ship?
They're prepping it now in the docking bay. The coordinates for Eos will be in the computer. And when you have a moment, we should discuss the missing arcs.
Yes, indeed.
I was wondering about
the... Okay.
Something wrong?
Ryder, please see me and Samnode on the Hyperion. Your implant needs attention, and we need to discuss a confidential matter.
No.
Okay.
I'm fine.
I still don't really feel comfortable with the AI in our heads, but... So that's talking to Tan, although... I can't talk to Tan again. Maybe I should do that while we're here. Can I scan anything? No. Okay, Arachta 10.
Ryder, you may have a less than flattering view of me, but I want to express my condolences for your father.
Thank you.
I appreciate it.
I didn't know him very well, although I understand he played a key role in planning the initiative. I'm sure he'd be concerned that we still have several arcs missing.
So, we know they don't know what happened to them, so I'll find them.
They're as much a part of the initiative as the human arc. We'll find them.
We have to. Tens of thousands of colonists are unaccounted for. It paints the initiative in an unflattering light.
Yeah, because that's the biggest problem. Maybe, because I'd like to talk with you a bit more. The missing arcs, don't think you can tell as much about that, but the Nexus troubles.
Sounds like the Nexus has had a rough time of it.
Publicly, I would say we're more than up for the challenge. Privately, I can tell you, it's been a disaster. The Scourge killed hundreds, many of them our senior leadership. Even the founder of the initiative, Gian Garson, is dead.
Gian Garson?
How did Gian Garson die?
With the rest of the leadership. When the Nexus hit Scourge, a large wing of stasis pods was destroyed. They were killed instantly. These people traveled 600 years and died before they even woke up. Gian Garson never glimpsed Helios. She never saw her vision realized.
That is really sad, but at least they didn't... I hope they didn't realize they died. So we did find a few things on Habitat 7.
We came across alien technology on Habitat 7. It seemed to affect the weather. Your people know anything about that?
There have been reports. Failed scouting missions have mentioned advanced structures of unknown design. Whatever they are, they defy explanation. But with our resources stretched so tight, no one has had a chance to study them. And what if the answer was bad for morale? Suppose these things turn people into food? All we know is the Ket are interested in them. I'd rather not stir things up.
Fair enough. What is your role exactly?
As director of the initiative, are you in charge around here or what?
If the others would allow me, they don't see me as the rightful successor.
Why the doubt?
What's their problem with you?
I am not Gian Garson. Our founder was charismatic, eccentric, larger than life. Traits I cannot hope to mimic. She and her inner circle perished in the Scourge, some at the hands of the Exiles. Some never made it out of stasis. I was deputy assistant for revenue management. Then all 7 leaders above me died. I was next in line for the
deputy role. Assistant for revenue management. So the... Accountant, I suppose.
So, you're an accountant?
There we go. Thank you, Sarah.
Don't let that fool you. We are all capable of more than we know. When I was young, I was fascinated by the idea of exploring space. Life had its detours, and I went a different direction. Then I heard about the initiative, and saw my chance to try the path not taken. While I may not be setting foot on new worlds, my authority can ensure that you do.
Right. Sorry.
Okay, then. The gridlock, I think we heard a bit about that, but maybe...
So how does anything get done?
In theory, Kesh handles the Nexus's physical operations, Kandros runs the militia, and Addison manages colonial affairs. I oversee all of it. In practice, we argue, debate, and yell at each other until a decision is made. If we're lucky. It is maddening.
Especially with all the different alien races mixed in between there, but other questions. Maybe just the Andromeda Initiative and then we'll say goodbye.
What more can you tell me about the Initiative?
It represents the greatest migration ever attempted. No one had ventured beyond the Milky Way before. We've all left home in search of freedom, fortune, perhaps a new beginning. We are the bravest souls each species has to offer. I hope the Nexus will serve as the seat of government for us all.
Kinda sounded like you read that from a spreadsheet, but how did it come to be?
What do you know about the early days of the Initiative?
As most everyone knows, Gian Garson's vision made it happen. She was an entrepreneur on Earth. Wealthy. Young for a human. Garson had the idea for the Initiative in the early 2170s, I believe. Many thought leaving the Milky Way was impossible. But she persevered. And as with most great ideas, the doubters were wrong.
Okay, and then... why did we even need a new world, actually?
Why do you think most people came?
There are thousands of reasons. One for every colonist here. What does any pilgrim seek? Usually, happiness. Finding the thing that eludes them. The thing to fulfill them. While we cannot promise they will find it, we can facilitate the search.
Okay, and how many alien species are there on the Nexus, then?
It looks like a melting pot around here.
The
Which
Nexus is,
good. Is
home to several Initiative species. Many came ahead of the Arks. The hope is that this station will one day serve as the governing body in Andromeda. Though I'm not sure what they were thinking, lumping Krogan into the mix.
Ooh.
As a Solarian, my kind tend to have a low opinion of them. Nothing I've seen here has changed that.
I'll actually elaborate on that a bit further, because Krogan were actually created by the Solarians to fight off. I'm not really sure what enemy it was originally, but they were created as a sort of workforce and mercenary army. But then, of course, they started to have ideas of their own. So I think that's pretty much what he's going to say now.
Why don't you like the Krogan?
It's common knowledge that they are a violent, ignorant species. Long ago, they waged nuclear war on one another. Their planet was decimated.
That's also true.
My people tried to uplift them, but the Krogan could never tame their worst instincts. What if they bring their tempers to Andromeda? We'll all be dead.
Oh, I think they, we kind of fixed that in Mass Effect 3, and I hope that still holds true, but thank you. Thank you, Tan.
That's all. Thanks for your time.
Of course. As you pointed out, we need each other. Our futures depend on each other's success.
Okay then. Tan checked off, and then we have Kesh, Kandros, and the scientists. Did we meet any of the scientists already?
Yeah.
Oh, speak with Sam on the Hyperion. No. Oh, Jesus Christ. Hello?
Hey, you okay?
I'm fine. My arms got the brunt of it.
Raj
Batil. Stuff exploding like this happen often?
Back right after the mutiny, we had a lot of this happening. But not lately.
I wasn't there during the mutiny.
Lucky. I thought we were done with this, honestly. That maybe I was just being paranoid.
Why paranoid?
What is there to be paranoid about?
We've had 3 malfunctions in the past week.
That's not good.
Oh, sabotage.
Sorry. Understatement.
Yeah. And now I have more repairs.
Did you report it to anyone?
Did you talk to security about this?
How can I? For all I know, someone in security is the one doing this.
And why would
I've scanned all the potential sabotage areas I can think of. But I don't know who to trust anymore.
Sounds like a lot went down before the Hyperion docked.
Yeah, I guess. Wait, that's it. You can't possibly be involved in this. You weren't even here during the mutiny.
Felt that
would
coming
you,
a mile
if
away.
If you have time, maybe you could help me. If they start hitting critical systems.
Fine.
Sure thing. What can I do?
If you could scan these other panels while I fix this one, that'd really help. I've sent the locations to your Omni-tool. Just send me the data when you're done.
Okay then. So I can't scan this panel then. Okay then, fair enough. I'll do that on the way. Maybe I should...
Be careful.
This one looks cool. This Asari looks really cool. But now... level up, your squad has leveled up. Upgrade Rider's combat abilities by purchasing combat tech or biotic skills. And select individual squad mates to upgrade them. I can't even see what the options are. Thank you. But where do I do that? Is that under inventory? Weapons? Skills, there we go, skills. Hello, Sarah. Combat, biotics, tech, and then the squad. Let's go with tech as a start. Unleashes an electrostatic discharge upon a target. High damage to shields and synthetic enemies detonates combo primers. Hold button charges overload, causing it to chain to two additional targets. I could use overload. I've always liked overload just because it can quickly remove shields. And I apparently have the points to activate it. So I have overload, concussive shot, and now I'm going to confirm it. Then I want to go into biotics. I need 9 skill points into biotics to unleash charge. And I really like charge because I used that in Mass Effect 2 and 3 when I did my insanity playthrough. And a lot of those I don't actually recognize. Lance, devastate a small area with a swiftly thrown shaft of energy. Inflicts bonus damage against enemy weak points and detonates combo primers. But I think I'm just going to go for pull as a basic biotic ability. There we go. That's good. And then we're going to go with Cora. Cora is probably more a biotic. Yeah, there we go. Select squad mate, charge, and Nova. Into a point blank high damage explosion around Cora. Asari Commando, but she's not an Asari. That's weird. Improves Cora's offensive abilities by honing her Asari Commando training. More shotgun damage and more shotgun force, or more max shields. I think I'm just gonna activate the first ranks of both of these just because they're a really nice boost. There we go. And then Liam. Let's go into his loadout. He's clearly a soldier. A frag grenade, havoc strike, or the military training. Might go for the military training and the defense the same way I did Cora. There we go. Thank you, guys. Thank you very much. And then we have inventory. Pistols. Do like the charger for close quarters combat. And I don't really have anything else at the moment. So we have the Omni Blade as a melee weapon. Assault rifles. Can I check the details? Yes. Oh. There we go. What's that armor look like? Let's equip that then. Not deconstruct. Can I check? I'm assuming I can't really equip that at the moment. Okay then. Let's swap the quest, of course. There we go, there it's back. Just gonna keep an eye out for every one of those panels I need to scan. So every time I enter a new room, I'm just gonna quickly scan around for any of those panels, although I don't really see anything right now. But there's a few things here. Sniper rifle barrel and a few credits. Just let's take all. And then a data pad for posterity in case the initiative goes belly up. Same shit, different day, by the way. The Nexus is a four-ring circus. Don't like how Tan operates, and his disdain for the Krogan is obvious. I believe his intentions are ultimately good, but he's an opportunist who's likely to create dissent. I don't see the Nexus coming together if he's left unchecked. It's already polarizing Edison, She's taking the cue to circle the wagons. I think I can talk to Kandros about this and at least try to get the two of us more coordinated. Or maybe not. Seriously hate this kind of drama. So this is clearly Cash. Hello, Cash. Let's have a little chat.
There you are. Hope the others haven't been giving you a hard time. There's a lot that needs doing.
Yes, indeed.
At least with the Hyperion hooked up and feeding us power, my team and I can get more work done.
Okay then, where are the rest of the Krogan?
I noticed there aren't a lot of Krogan around.
You haven't spoken to Number 8 yet, have you?
Number 8?
Tan. Ask him why most of my people left. He'll have opinions.
Yeah, we kind of know that already. I can tell you this much.
When the mutiny happened, a deal was made. My clan were supposed to settle matters and, in return, get more say in the initiative.
The Krogan deal with Tan, Number 8.
Why do you call Tan 8?
Because he was 8th in line to take over.
Oh yeah, right,
Andromeda,
we kinda knew that already.
I like to remind him of that now and then. Keep him humble.
Probably a good idea since we've met the man.
Did the deal go through?
The clan held up their part, but Tan had a meltdown when he found out we wanted more say around here. Then Addison's assistant, Spender, pretended he never made the deal in the first place.
It was
a mess, but I don't blame my people for walking out. We're done being used.
Okay, why are you still here then?
With your clan gone, why did you stay?
It's complicated. The station and my clan both need me here.
Okay. Your job exactly.
What kind of work do you do as superintendent?
I was part of the team that originally designed and built this place.
Oh, cool.
I keep the station functional, or as functional as possible, considering.
The Genophage, so that's the, if I'm not mistaken, that made every Krogan, well, most of the Krogan, infertile. So that might have had an effect on her as well.
When we left the Milky Way, the Krogan were still dealing with the Genophage.
Right. The Genophage. A little gift to our people from the Salarians thousands of years ago. That sterility virus they infected us with left most of our children stillborn. Only 1 in 1,000 survive.
And how's the cure going? Because we kinda... You could fix the Genophage in Mass Effect 3. It was one of the bigger choices you can make, so...
What about the Krogan here in Andromeda?
There's no cure for it. But my clan was starting to show a mutation against the virus. A natural defense.
Ah, interesting.
During the trip to get here, Krogan underwent gene therapies to enhance the mutation while we were in stasis.
So you used those 600 years to your advantage. Gave the adaptation more time to develop.
Yeah. It's still early, but I think we made a dent. Our scientists say we've improved viability to almost 4%, which is a lot better than what we had. Beyond all the statistics, it means more Krogan children will live. It's the only way my people have a future out here.
That is weird, because why would that improve while you're in stasis? Why would that even evolve when you're in stasis? Stasis, well, clearly means that you're, well, not changing in any way.
What sort of problems have you seen on the Nexus?
Situation's gone to shit pretty much sums it up. There's arcs missing. Some idiots tried to mutiny and take over, then more idiots offended my clan, so they left. And to top it all off, the founder of the Initiative, Gian Garson, was killed.
We kinda knew about Gian Garson as well, so... More about Nexus problems.
And I thought the Hyperion had it bad when we arrived. Anything else?
The outposts aren't happening because we don't have resources or people, so Addison's more uptight than ever. And let's not forget how badly the station was damaged on arrival. But that's a detail, according to some. My team and I are repairing what we can. If we don't get materials soon, things will go downhill. Fast.
So I'm starting to feel there's a lot of areas we can help in, so let's go back to the questions. I think I'm just gonna say goodbye to Cash.
Nothing more for now.
See you later.
So that leaves only one more person, the Turian we started talking to when we got here. So the leader of the militia here, Tyrion, I think his name was Tyrion Kandros. Probably over there on the right, judging by the uniforms. Although I might be mistaken, of course. Nope, there we go. Hello, Kandros.
I know that look. The others bent your ear, did they?
Something like that?
You get used to it.
Just focus on being a Pathfinder. Can't argue with results, though they'll try. Anyway, welcome to Militia HQ. Excuse the mess. This office fields militia work, Nexus security, and looking for the Turian Ark.
What's the word on the Turian Ark?
Scattered readings. Some indicate the Natanis was destroyed, others that people are alive. Who knows? If you need anything, come see me, even if it's just a vent.
Okay, can you tell me a bit more about the Ket?
What do you know about the enemies we've encountered? The Ket?
We usually see them on worlds with those alien structures. The Ket don't take kindly to anyone studying them. Not sure why. They don't talk to us. Every time we cross paths, there's a fight or they take prisoners.
Why? What do they want?
No one knows. But I've seen their weaponry and what they do to those prisoners. I want them a long, long way from the Nexus.
Okay, and why? How is the militia used then if you don't want to attack anybody?
It's rough out there. I might need backup if you can spare the people.
I have strike teams specializing in assault and extraction. If you need serious firepower, my Apex teams have you covered. In fact, I could give you authority to dispatch them. It'll cut down their response time.
Thank you.
Our current ops are on the terminal. See if there's anything that could use a shot where it counts.
So there we go, and that links into the multiplayer, because those Apex missions, you can actually play yourself in the multiplayer, so that's pretty cool. Turian welfare.
Are the other Turians managing okay?
So-so. We're not good at sitting around in a crisis. Service before self gets drummed into us at boot camp. That's probably why so many of us are in the militia. We like to earn our citizenship, whatever galaxy we're in. But it's hard to
that
focus.
That is amendable. And your role specifically
you
in that?
You talk like you weren't part of the leadership. How did you end up commanding the militia?
I was escorting a prospecting team on some moon when those Ket found us. They penned us like cattle for experiments. I managed to get loose, snatched a gun, and freed the others. By the time we killed the bastards and headed back to warn the Nexus, everyone looked at me like I was in charge.
That sounds familiar.
The militia grew from there. Funny, once the heat is on, all kinds of people rise to the top.
Yeah, interesting indeed. And why did you come to Andromeda?
What brought you out here to Andromeda?
I was tired of being the good one.
The good one?
The Kandros family is old military. There were expectations, you know. Then my sister became a sculptor, and cousin Nyrene went pirate on Omega. Everyone was proud that
Nyrene.
I stayed in service. But I kept wondering, when do I get my adventure? Jen Garson's dream was so grand, so gutsy, I had to be part of it.
That's interesting, because Nyrene is one of the cooler characters from the Omega DLC. A very badass Turian lady. But, yeah, thank you. Thank you, Kandros.
Bye, Kandros. Duty calls.
You and me both, Pathfinder.
Those are some interesting stories already, so... Well, now that we're here, we might as well talk to the scientist as well. That looks... Is that one of those panels? No. This is not one of those panels. There is a datapad here, though. So, Apex status. Lieutenant! Or Lieutenant? Based on status report 16C, it seems we're no closer to gaining a foothold in any sector. Without decent recon and greater intel on this enemy, I'm starting to think our efforts are futile. The risks involved and continued loss of resources and lives makes it hard to justify. With morale this low, we need to scale down expectations again. Kandros himself, apparently.
What am I going to do?
That gives us a bit of supplies as well. Mariette, what is your problem?
It's not right. It's not fair.
What's
wrong? She kind of looks like a kitty.
Oh my, you're... So it's true. A Pathfinder has found us. There's hope at last. Maybe you could help. You're impartial. This whole thing has gotten so political. My husband, he's locked up and slated for exile for a crime he didn't commit.
Okay. What was the crime?
What exactly was he convicted of?
They don't exile you for petty theft. Well, maybe this bunch would. They say it's murder. They're calling him the first murderer in Andromeda, but the dead man was his friend. He wouldn't have... There are witnesses and evidence, but it's all circumstantial. At worst, it was an accident. His name is Nilkin Rensis. He could give you the details if you were willing to speak with him. Please.
Of course.
I'd be happy to.
Sounds like an interesting episode.
Oh, thank you. I'm sure the jailer will allow you a visit. Please, tell Nilkin I love him.
Oh, so he's... Oh, so he's slated for exile, but he's not exiled just yet, which is interesting. Oh, that's one of the... God damn it. The damage done to this site was caused by a direct override of the safety locks. Numerous people are listed as working here. I will cross-reference all other data. Interesting. Anything else I need to scan? Probably not. So let's just head over to the scientists and talk with them as our last stop. Is that? Yeah, over there. He was sliding across the floor. They have a fancy outfits, by the way. Kind of looks a bit funny. Professor Herrick. Hello? Can I talk to him? No? Well, I need to stand in front of him to talk.
You must be the Pathfinder. Wonderful. You and your Sam are exactly what we need.
Thanks, Mr.
Professor Herrick. My colleagues and I will work with your Sam and the data you gather to solve Andromeda's scientific mysteries.
Can I join in?
I'm usually out in the field, but I wouldn't mind talking shop. Or lab. You know.
You are always welcome.
Not that we've had much to study, with everyone cooped up for 14 months.
But your data on the Scourge flows like poetry. Now we can better advise on repairing the damage it caused.
And maybe Addison will give us a real workspace. Who can think with all this racket?
That was a funny little... Dude, three skill points. I just got three skill points. That was awesome. I need to do more quests, so let's check that out. So under skills, I suppose? Yes, indeed. I have four skill points now, so I think I'm just going to boost my biotics a bit further. Pool is really cool, and I might just upgrade a few of those abilities, although I might go into passive abilities as well. What the? Just plus 2%? What? Wait, what? That is ridiculously low. Is that right? Is that the same under combat? Holy shit. That is just, yeah, it just adds 2% damage. That is, I would say stupid. 2%. Say what now? So I really need to focus into one or two trees. I never liked the combat skill. So I'm not going to head any further into that. So I'm even going to probably just detonate combo primers, which is fine. But I think I'm just going to go into biotics and tech because I really just like that more. Let's upgrade pool to just recharge a bit faster. And then I'm going to also go into offensive biotics. No, you know what? I'm just going to, I'm just going to confirm that and just overload, there we go. Put some more recharge speed on overload as well. So now we have a few extra skills that we can use to, well, we can make some combos as well with that. So that is really, really good. Good. There we go. And Cora and Liam also got 2 points extra. So we might, I'm going to boost Cora's charge just so she can do that a bit more often. And then Liam can go into his, yeah, just go with his frag grenade, just to recharge his frag grenade a bit faster. Not a bit faster, just a bit faster. And there we go. That's the introduction to the Nexus and everybody in it. Seems like we're pretty well confined to this area for now. So the main area over there with two rooms and then this hub area kind of. So with that done, I'm gonna take a little break. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And, well, I guess I'll see you guys in the next episode. Goodbye. Honest.